The way that we reduce the amount of power that goes to the motors is with a series of resistor grids, and they reduce the amount of power that gets to those motors.
The blue resistor portion of this animation represents the resistor grid that would be mounted under the car. When we're in first point, that resistor section would be very long and really limiting the power that's able to get from the pole to the motors. As we work ourselves up through the points on the controller, that resistor section would effectively get shorter, allowing more power through until we shed the grid completely and all 600 volts is applied to the motors.
How we operate those grids is with this handle, and we'll see that there are various points in the control. When we take the first point, all of the resistance is being used to gradually meter power to the motor. And as we work through the points, more and more of the resistor grid is shed, letting more of the 600 volts through to power the trolley. This is what a trolley controller looks like in the inside, and it's got a series of components. This whole area here, behind my hand, is just about determining the direction that the motors go in. In this position, the trolley is set to go in this direction. Pull it past neutral and backward, and now the trolley motors are set to go in this direction. We had mentioned the resistor grid and how when we're in the first point, we're using all of that resistor grid to hold back the full power from the trolley wire down to the motors. As we go into other positions, we can see parts of the mechanism in here that help the power go through the appropriate parts of the grid. And as we advance point by point, we're routing power around that grid, and more of it goes directly to the motors until we get to this position here, and all of the voltage from the overhead wire is going through the motors now. We'll show you now how the controller works. In first point, the entire resistor grid is engaged and the trolley motors get a small amount of power. We move on to the second point and they get a little bit more of that 600 volts. Another point and they get more. Another point, more. This controller has one more point and now the motors are getting full voltage and we're at maximum speed.